finite verbs and non-finite verbs. Okay, we are going to learn the finite verbs and non-finite verbs today. You're all familiar with the concept finite verb, and I know that you know a little bit about non-finite verb, but this year we are going to learn in detail the topic finite and non-finite verb. Let me introduce the concept finite verb first to you. Okay, so the finite verbs, the other name for the finite verb is a complete verb. Why it is called a complete verb? Because we are able to identify the exact time of action. Okay, I can even say that, okay, this action is performing. This action has already performed, or this action will be performing in the very next day, right? So I can predict, I can tell the time, the exact time of action by looking at the verb. So the verb which helps us to identify the tense form is coming under the category called finite verb. Okay. And remember, this finite verb, it should have a subject of its own. It is a must that it should have a subject of its own. So the problem is, the finite verb is always controlled and limited by the subject, children. It is not free. It changes its form according to the subject changes. That means if the subject is singular, the finite verb changes its form, right? It should be singular in form. Okay, if the subject is plural, it should change its form. It should be plural in form. Okay, and at the same time, that should be limited in number and person. I said number means English grammar, we have only two numbers, singular number and plural number. So finite verb, it changes its form according to the number of the subject and according to the person. Person in the sense, you are familiar with first person pronoun, second person pronoun, third person pronoun, isn't it? Yes. So according to the person, we make a few changes in the form of finite verb. If the subject is I, you can use only am with writing, right? If the subject is you, though it is singular or plural, never mind, use are with you, right? If the subject is I again, you need to use have, the auxiliary verb with the subject, right? So whenever you change the subject of your sentence in number and in person, there is a change that is coming in the place of finite verb also. So remember, a finite verb is always controlled, always limited by the subject in number and in person. Am I clear? The concept is clear. So let me introduce this concept once again to you. So let us start from verb, that is finite and non-finite verbs. Okay. Let us see what is a finite verb. Remember, I have told you we have 12 tense forms in English grammar. So your finite verb should be any one of the 12 tense forms. Okay. It will be written in any one of the 12 tense form. We have 12 tense form, 4 under past tense, 4 under present tense, 4 under future tense, right? So that should be a finite verb, should be any one of the 12 tense forms written in English grammar. At the same time, if we talk about non-finite verb, these non-finite verbs are also derived, or this is formed from a verb. There is no doubt. But this is not used in the form of a verb in a sentence. Okay. We cannot use these non-finite verb as a verb in a sentence. If it is not used as a verb, what is in the form then? How it is used in a sentence, verb, children?
Auxiliary verb?
No.
Verb?
No. It has some other function. These non-finite verbs, it acts like an adjective in a sentence. Okay, it is in the form of a verb, but it acts like a, or it functions like a, like an adjective or like a noun in a sentence. Okay, yes, so a non-finite verb is derived or formed from a verb. It is in the form of a verb. It looks like a verb, but it is not in function. It is not a verb in function. It acts like an adjective in a sentence. It acts like a noun in a sentence. I'll teach you how is it possible. And I said, children, finite verbs are always limited, always controlled by its subject, right? Its subject in number and in person. But here in noun finite, it does not have a subject of its own. We cannot even identify the tense form by looking at a noun finite verb. Okay, I have told it is not possible for us to identify the tense form by looking at the finite, noun finite verb, right? Suppose if I say, I like to jump. Okay, I like to jump. So the word to jump. Are you able to identify the tense form by looking at the word to jump?
No, ma'am.
It is not possible for us to identify, isn't it? I cannot even identify what is this to jump. No way. Okay, let me write the sentence on the word and I will explain this to you.
Excuse me, ma'am.
You're excused.
Ma'am, if that word jump comes under present tense?
But I have added a word to. The preposition to is added before this, right? Yes. So it is not coming under the present tense because the word is to jump.
It's
so
like
let me
future,
explain.
Ma'am. Yes, I like to jump.
To like jump. That. So?
Yeah, okay. Ma'am, I think so. I cannot say.
It is wrong. It is wrong. Yeah, don't think like
we
that. Because if a verb is preceded by a to, this is coming under the category called non-finite verb. This is not a finite ma'am. Verb. You won't be able to identify the tense. Okay?
Yes.
Let me explain this concept once again. A finite verb. This finite verb, sometimes it acts like a main verb in a sentence. Okay, I have told a few minutes before, a finite verb, it has a subject of its own. Okay, it has a subject of its own. Okay, and because of that, okay, the subject, it controls the finite verb in number and in person. Now you look at here, I have an example. I live in Germany. Okay, I live in Germany. Tell me the finite verb used in this sentence.
Live.
Okay, live. Agree. Live. Tell me the subject of this finite verb.
I is the subject.
I
okay.
Is the subject.
I have told in my sentence. Suppose if your sentence is a finite verb, it has a finite verb. This finite verb is limited and controlled by the subject, right? You said, okay, but you did not get it. Now let me explain this to you once again. Suppose if I change this I, the subject, into he. Okay, I was the first person pronoun. Now I am planning to change the I first person pronoun into he third person pronoun. Is it right to say he live in Germany?
No, ma'am.
He lives in Germany. No, correct.
How are you going to correct this?
He lives in Germany, right?
Because the subject is singular and third person pronoun he. So the finite verb is controlled by the subject, right? Because I need to change the finite verb from live to lives as the subject is not I, it is he. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Suppose now if your sentence is they live. Okay, if your sentence is they live in Germany. Okay, they live in Germany. Here, my subject is they. Okay, so there is no need for changing live the verb because they, the plural subject, takes always a plural verb with it, right? So according to the subject, according to the number, according to the pronoun, the word or the finite verb, it changes its form. Okay, such verbs are called finite verbs. So remember, it has a subject on its own. At the same time, now, when we talk about noun finite verb, if I write a sentence like this, okay, let me write another sentence on the board, children. If the sentence is, I like to run. Okay, this is my sentence. I like to run. In this sentence, you can find a finite verb and you can find a noun finite verb. Tell me which one is finite and which one is non finite.
Like the finite verb and to run is the non finite.
To run is the non finite verb. Okay, suppose, look at here, children. Suppose if I change I into he, If I change the subject of the finite verb, I into he, what change occur here?
I have to change like into likes, right?
Whenever I change the subject of a finite verb, here the changes occur, but here it remain constant, right? It is not changing, right? He likes to run also correct. I like to run also correct, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
So this non-finite verb, it does not have a subject of its own. Remember, it does not have a subject of its own. It is not possible for us to identify the tense of a sentence by looking at a non-finite verb. And this non-finite verb is not controlled by the subject of the sentence. Clear? Clear. Whenever I change the subject of the sentence, the non-finite verb remain as it is. There is no change. Clear? So this non-finite verb is not limited by the subject of the sentence. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I clear? So let me discuss finite verb once again. I have told finite verb will be written any one of the 12 tense forms in English grammar, right?
Finite verb.
Who is speaking?
Angelina Jones.
Angelina?
Yes, ma'am.
What do you want to know?
Ma'am, I have doubt in non-finite verb, ma'am.
Ask me.
Ma'am, as you told, the finite verbs are limited by the subject. Non-finite is not limited. So how will we look that? And means how will I identify it is a non-finite verb?
I'll teach you. The non-finites are coming. Okay. Now let us concentrate finites. Okay. Keep this point in your mind. Finite verbs are limited by its subject, but non-finite, it never changes its form. It remains as it is in a sentence, even if we are changing the subject of the sentence also. Keep this point in your mind and I'll teach you what are the non-finite forms. Okay. So children, listen. Now you listen here. Here we have one sentence. I have changed this one single sentence into its 12 tense form. That means all these verbs are written in finite verb. Okay. I write a letter. Write is the finite verb here, which shows the time of action. The sentence is written in simple present tense, right?
Yes, ma'am.
I am writing a letter. Chinmay, I am writing a letter. Chinmay, tell me the tense of the sentence. Chinmay?
Present tense.
What present?
Present continuous.
Anandesh Spy, I have written a letter. What is the tense of the sentence?
Present perfect.
Present perfect. Atvika PA, I have been writing a letter. What is the tense of the sentence? Atvika, what is the tense of the sentence? I have been writing a letter. Advika, can you hear me? Gautam?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the tense of the sentence, I have been writing a letter?
Present perfect continuous.
Okay. Cheryl Mary, I wrote a letter. What is the tense?
Simple past.
Okay. Manu? Manu?
Ma'am?
Manu, tell me the tense of I had written a letter.
I had written a letter. Past perfect.
Okay. Adinath Snayer. Adinath. I had been writing a letter. Tense.
Past perfect continuous.
Okay. Next one. Agne Emanan. Agne, I will write a letter.
Simple future.
Okay. Next question. I think I can ask Pavitra Girish. Pavitra, I will be writing a letter.
Future continuous.
Ayman. I will have written a letter. Ayman? Angelina Jos? I will have written a letter.
I will have written a letter. Future perfect.
Okay. Sri Shankar? I will have been writing a letter.
Ma'am, future perfect continuous.
Future perfect continuous. How did you identify all these verbs, all these sentences, all the tenses? By looking at the finite verb. So, Rasin Sohra, please tell me the finite verbs written in the sentence, in all the present tense sentences here.
Yes, ma'am. First one, write.
Okay.
Second one, am writing.
Okay.
Third one, have written.
Okay.
Fourth one, have been writing.
Excellent. Thank you. So next, Rohit K. Jain. Rohit, tell me the finite verb written in the past tense.
Wrote.
Okay.
Writing.
Excellent.
Had written.
Okay.
Had been writing.
Okay. Future tense. I think I can ask this question to Jovan B. Paul. Jovan, tell me the future tense finite verbs.
The first one is will write. Second one will be writing. Third one will have written. And last one will have been writing.
Excellent. These are the examples. Okay. So please keep this in your mind. A finite verb is a main verb. It can be the complete verb of a sentence, which shows the exact time of action. If there is any auxiliary verb used in your sentence, you can attach those auxiliary verbs along with the main verb to frame the proper finite verb. Okay. So this finite verb will be written in any one of the 12 tense forms in English grammar. Am I clear? Do you have any doubt here?
Very clear, ma'am. No doubt.
It is very clear. And remember, this finite verb are always limited and always controlled by its subject in number and subject in person. That is why with I we have used have, isn't it? We cannot use has. Okay. And with you we can use only are. We cannot even ever think about using is with that, right? And along with I we can use am. We cannot even use is with I, right? So always these finite verbs are limited, controlled by the subject of its sentence. Yes.
I was or I will.
I was. I were used sometimes. When there is a wish. I wish I were a bird. At present, I am a human being. I cannot be a bird, right? So if I wish, I wish I were a bird. This is a Thursday. This is Thursday morning. So I can say that I wish this were Saturday weekend, right? I wish it were Saturday. Okay. I wish I were a bird, right? Okay, along with I wish, you can use where. There is nothing wrong to use with where. With I, because if there is a wish, if you make a wish, you can use where with I. Exceptional case, not always. Okay, I was working with him. Okay, was is the right usage. Okay, now children, let us talk about non-finite form. As you all know, non-finite, I have told, there are three forms coming under the non-finite form. Angelina, please listen. So yes, we are going to talk about okay, I'm going to change the color of the sentence. Sorry, board.
Yes, ma'am. You please explain it.
The word is, the word for you is non-finite. I request everybody to note this. You are familiar, but still you need to write again. Non-finite verbs. I request everybody to write this. Non-finite verbs. It is not possible for us to identify the tense form by looking at the non-finite verb. And this non-finite verb is further divided into three. We have three different non-finite verbs. You learned last year, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The first one is to infinitive.
We should write this in our notes.
Yes, in a paper. To infinitive. The first non-finite verb is to infinitive. Second non-finite verb is participle. You are familiar with past and present participles, right?
Yes, ma'am. Participle.
Participle. Second one, participle. Third one, gerund. Third verb form,
gerund.
I request everybody to copy this. First one, non-finite. It is divided into three. Two infinitive, participle, gerund. This participle is again divided into two. We have
past.
Present participle
and past participle.
Yes. Present past participle. And second one, past participle. Past. Okay, now let us talk about two infinitive. Children, two infinitives are normally used in the form of a noun in a sentence. Okay, wherever we use a subject. See, what is the position of a subject in a sentence? Subject is always placed before the verb in a sentence, yes, isn't it?
Yes.
Anju is a teacher. So is an auxiliary verb. Though it is a verb, in the sentence it acts like a main verb, right? Okay, so Anju, the noun, is placed before the verb in the sentence. So wherever you use a subject of a sentence, those all places you can use this two infinitive form as in the form of a noun. So if it is a noun in form, that can be used in the position of object also after the verb. Okay, so it can be used in the position of subject. 2 plus base form can be used in the position of a subject before the verb. This can also be used in the position of object after a verb in a sentence. Remember, two infinitives are 2 plus base form of the verb. 2 plus base form. It can be written in the form of 2 plus base form of the verb.
Ma'am, example, so these kind of verbs are mean to say non-finite?
Yes, 2 plus base forms are coming under the category called non-finite verb. This okay, is easy ma'am. To understand. This is position before a verb in a sentence in the position of a subject. This can be seen in the position of an object after a verb in a sentence. Yes. Okay. Only this much. You need to learn only this much. You will be getting more idea in 8th standard. Okay. We are going to learn in detail everything by keeping in different branches in 8th standard. Ma'am. Okay. Ma'am. Now you just keep this in your mind. Non-finite verbs are. Wait a minute, children. Non-finite verbs are not easy. It is not it by looking at a non-finite verb, it is not possible for us to identify a tense form. In function, it is not a verb. It is used in the form of a noun. It can be used in the form of an adjective in a sentence. A non-finite verb that can be used in the form of by function. It can be used in the form of adjective or noun. Okay. Adjective or noun in a sentence. Two infinitives are normally used in the position of a subject and object in the form of a noun. Okay. So two infinitives are 2 plus base form. That is to jump. To run. Okay. To play.
To sing.
To play. To sing.
To sleep.
To swim.
To
sleep.
Fly.
To fly.
To sing. To dance.
To fly. Only base form. To dance.
To dance.
To write.
To study.
To teach. Okay. To write. To teach.
To study.
To study.
Very good. To study. Okay, these are the 2 plus base form.
To learn.
If you see these forms are there in your sentence before a verb or after a verb in the position of subject and object, you can say that, okay, this is used in the form of a noun in a sentence. Okay. Okay. And these are non-finite verbs. See, by looking at the non-finite verb to infinitive, we are unable to identify the tense form. See, to play. There is no tense form there, right? To play. To sleep, there is no tense form. To dance, this is not a finite verb. To teach, this is not a finite verb. So if a base form is attached with a to, the preposition, this is a to infinitive form, this is a non-finite verb, this is not limited by the subject. Okay? Keep only this thing in your mind.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, now the second one, children. Second one, participle. See, this past and participles are also known as verbal adjectives. I request everybody to note this. Verbal adjectives. Participles are also known as verbal adjectives. Why? Because this is in the form of a verb, but it is used before a noun to describe a noun in the form of an adjective. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, participles are present participle and past participle. And those present and past participles are also called verbal adjective. Yes, someone is asking something. If you're not getting, you tell me because this is a new topic.
Ma'am, I didn't understand this one, ma'am.
You did not understand? participle. Okay, I'm not writing anything on the board. Let me speak looking at your eyes. See, children, we are going to talk about the noun finite verb. Okay, so let me explain the noun finite verb. I have told you these noun finite verbs are like, it is look alike a verb. Okay, like jumping, like written, present and past participle form, like moving, okay, like bouncing, okay, all these words are examples, okay, these are ing forms. This is just like a present participle, right? This is just like a verb, right? If it is attached, if you attach this present participle or past participle form along with an auxiliary verb, then this can be called a finite verb, okay? He's jumping, are bouncing, okay? If this is used with an auxiliary verb, then you can call it as a finite verb. But suppose if these words, okay, this is in the form of a verb, but these words are used before a noun in the form of an adjective, like moving train, okay? The word moving train, are you able to identify the tense by looking at the word moving?
No, ma'am.
If it is the train is moving, then okay, is moving is the finite verb, isn't it?
It's now moving.
Yes, ma'am.
Because you can identify the tense, is moving, present continuous, isn't it? But yes. I have said, I am in a moving train.
Yes, ma'am. Moving train.
Moving train. Moving, moving. The train is moving. Yes. Moving train, okay? Yes. It is not moving, cow moves, no. I am in a moving train. Moving train, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay? So yes, if I am in a moving train, okay, just try to understand. I have placed the word moving before the noun train in the form of an adjective.
Yes.
Yeah, ma'am.
Suppose if my sentence is, I have a bouncing ball, bouncing ball. The word bouncing, by looking at the word bouncing, we are not able to identify the tense, yes, isn't it?
It is like an adjective, ma'am.
But it is used, if this ing form is used before a noun, like bouncing ball. So the ball is not stationary, it is moving, right? It is bouncing, going, coming up, raising high and going down, right? Bouncing, bouncing ball. So the word bouncing, the ing form, the present participle form is used before a noun in the form of an adjective. Then it is a non-finite verb. Okay, if you attach this participle with an auxiliary verb, that definitely in the form of a finite verb. If there is no such auxiliary verbs, but we have used these words, these ing forms, these past participle before a noun in the form of an adjective to describe the noun, then we have to label it as a non-finite verb. Clear?
Yes, now I understand.
Clear? Am I clear? Yes. Jovin, are you getting this?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear? Is that clear for you?
Yes, ma'am.
Chinmay, is it clear?
Yes.
Agnay, is that clear for you?
Yes.
Anantesh?
Ma'am, before it was not clear. Now it is clear.
It is clear because you got a little bit confused with finite and non-finite, right? You may be thinking, okay, how can I identify if there is ease is there? Right? It is coming under the finite verb. Is it clear now?
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Manu.
Clear. I'm clear.
I'm clear to the sentence that past participle is an adjective.
Why not? I can say that a painted
that's
house.
Written like
painted house.
Okay, ma'am.
Painted house means the word painted. Okay, as used, it is the past participle form of the verb paint, right? So painted is used before a noun house. Painted house. I am in a painted house. Oh my God. That is not right in use, right? Painted house. Okay, yes, then what else? What else? What else? You give me some examples. Broken glass.
I mean,
broken glass. The glass is broken. Broken glass. I am actually using a past participle form, broken, in front of a noun that is a glass. So here, broken is not used as a finite verb and it is used in the form of an adjective which qualifies a noun glass, isn't it?
Written notes.
Very good. Very good. Written notes.
Eaten apple.
Excellent. Eaten apple. Then.
Excuse me. Missing
movie.
Ma'am, can this sentence be under part?
Missing movie.
Ma'am, can this?
Both vegetables.
Ma'am, it's not clear.
Ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes, Angelina.
Ma'am, can this sentence come under that? I have got a bounced ball.
A bounced ball?
No.
Yes, ma'am.
Bouncing ball is
no.
It's a passed word.
Yeah, ma'am, that I'm asking.
Ma'am, dancing toy.
Dancing toy. Good example. Dancing toy. It's a good example. Yeah, okay. Ma'am. Any other examples? Give me. Past participle. Oh, yeah. Past participle flying or aeroplane. Present participle used in the form of a
moving, moving ball.
Flying helicopter.
Flying helicopter. Missing very good.
Throwing ball.
Throwing tiger. Training tiger.
No, no, wait a minute. Boy, wait a minute. Yeah. Angelina is sharing something. Angelina Jose.
Yes, ma'am. Trained tiger.
Trained tiger. Very good. Trained tiger.
Flowing river.
Flowing river. Excellent.
Missing
you can not all these examples, children.
Ma'am, shining glass.
Shining glass. Shining glass. Excellent. Excellent.
Flying birds.
Flying birds.
Wonderful.
Crying animals.
Crying baby.
Missing movie.
Crying baby. Oh, what crying is it?
Missing movie.
Okay, enough. I request everybody to stop because Jovan is putting his finger inside his ears and just showing this, ma'am, it's getting irritated. My eyebrows are raising high.
That's too loud.
Because of the frequency. So everyone, please, teachers, we all are deaf now because of your voice. Okay. So children, try to understand the situation. So let us stop here with the examples. And this is the end of today's class. And I have a request for you guys. You are keeping an album of yours, right? You have a word book with you. Word dictionary, pocket dictionary with you. So please prepare two sheets with the present participle and past participle used in the form of adjectives. We'll have a discussion in the next class. Bye.
Activity.
It's an activity. It's an activity. Write participles in the form of adjectives. Okay, you can write the heading. You can give the heading. The verbal adjectives.
Like
verbs in the form of adjectives.
Should we submit it?
First, you listen, children. You have to write a title. You can do it in an A4 size sheet. Okay, one single sheet is enough. Okay, you write heading, verbal adjectives. Divide that sheet into two pieces. One column you can write a present participle. The other column you can use a past participle. And write a present participle before a noun and fill present participle column and past participle used before a noun in the form of an adjective and fill that column. Thank you so much for coming here and attending my session. Meet you in the next class. Bye.
Thank you.